Hi, I'm Sebastian from Beamex. In this video, you will learn how to connect the MC6 to an air-operated HART valve and to perform a linearity test for the same valve. What you see here at the bottom is the valve itself. On top, we have an actuator, and in front, we have the digital valve controller. The MC6 will be generating a current signal, which the digital controller will be reading as an input signal. Simultaneously, an output signal, a HART signal, which contains the travel variable, will be read by the MC6 HART communicator. First, I'm going to explain how to connect the MC6 to the controller. The easiest way to see if your connections are done properly and if the control and valve are operating as they should is to use the calibrator mode on the MC6. And since we're going to be generating a current signal, I want it to be in the upper window. I choose current, and for out generation, I see here that I need to connect to these two terminals. I take two test leads, connect them to the terminals as shown in the picture. Also on the other side on the controller. And now, if I have air supply on to the control and to the valve, I should hear movement when I have a milliamp signal higher than 4 milliamps. So let's generate 5 milliamps and see what happens. I heard that something moved inside of the valve. This means that my connections are done properly and also that the controller and valve are operating. The second thing I need to do is to connect test leads for the HART signal to travel from the controller to the MC6. But before I do that, I need to connect an external 250 ohm resistor, since the instrument is being powered by the current line of the MC6. I connect it here and put the test lead back to the MC6, and we can continue with the procedure. If you don't have an external 250 ohm resistor, you can try if the MC6 finds the instrument by setting the HART communicator to high sensitivity mode. You do that in the settings. Go to second page. You find HART, and on that second page, you choose sensitivity mode to high. In this high sensitivity mode, the MC6 tries to connect to the HART signal on lower signal levels than the HART standard defines. If you have enough impedance on your supply line, the MC6 should be able to connect to the instrument even without an external resistor. We are back in the calibrator mode, and now let's connect the HART instrument to the communicator. We want to have the HART signal in the second window, so we'll choose HART. We have external supply, and now we also need to connect the test leads to the HART signal, so we'll do that parallel to the current supply line. First on the controller side, and then to the communicator side, like that. Found the instrument, and I have sorted the menu in a way that the MC6 is only going to be showing me the measurable variables. This way it's easier to find what I'm looking for, because otherwise I'm going to be searching through all the variables in the instrument itself. Now I found it. I choose to travel. Choose OK. And now I can test that if everything is working properly. At 4 milliamps, I should have 0% travel. Looks good. 20 milliamps, I should have 100% travel. And that also looks good. Now we are ready to continue to the linearity test. Next, I will perform the automatic linearity test for the valve. And to do so, I will be using the MC6 documenting calibrator mode. But before I go any further, I need to have the instrument established in the calibrator. I can either have it sent over from a Beamex calibration management software, or I can create it straight in the MC6. And that's what I'm going to do now. So I go to the documenting calibrator, create new instrument. And for the input signal, the current generation, I see current is already chosen, but at the moment there's 0 milliamps being generated, meaning that the instrument, the valve, is not powered up. That means that I'm not going to be able to read an HART signal since there's zero milliamps going in at the moment. To correct this, I go to menu and choose initial values and enter anything above 4 milliamps. So let's generate 5 milliamps. I heard that it powered up. Everything is working. I go to the next page, which is output. And this is where I'm going to choose HART and connect to the HART instruments. External supply. It's now connecting. It found it. And in the same way as in the previous test, I have the MC6 only filtering and showing me measurable variables. This way it's much easier for me to find what I'm looking for. And the travel variable is the one that we're going to be connecting to for the linearity test. We found it. Choose it. It's reading out well. Now we can go to the function. And the input range is going to be 4 to 20 milliamps. That's already there. The output range, 0 to 100%. That's also there. Let's give this a name. Linearity test. Let's go to the procedure. This is going to be 5 points up and down, so we're going to change this parameter, and I want the MC6 to record all the different set points and readings from them. So choose automatic acceptance. Let's go to the error limits. This is something that all of your different procedures and company standards tell you what to have. I'm going to be set it to 3% of span. And identification, I'm also going to give it the same name, linearity test. As so. Now I've saved it. I can see all the parameters are correct. The position, the input range, the HART, the output range. If I wouldn't have this connected already, I could then see how to make my connections. Now let's start the test. I'm now going to be pressing the start button. After this, the MC6 will perform the home linearity test automatically for me. I don't have to be writing down anything or like that. We see in the top left corner, we have the input milliamp signal for the controller. We also have the output HART signal, the travel variable in percentages in the right side. On the bottom right side, we have the different set points given by the calibrator or the MC6. The blue upper and lower limits, that's my error limits that I set previously when creating the instrument. The green dots here are my recorded set points. And as long as I stay within these two blue lines, I'm going to have a passed test. And I don't have to calculate anything. I see that the MC6 is constantly calculating and showing me the error, which is great, makes my life easier. We are almost already done with the linearity test. I'm just going to now let the MC6 record the final point, and we're going to be finished. It's a passed test. I can enter who did the test. It is me in this case. Also, if I want to add any notes for this test, I could do so here. I can view my results in the graphical view or in the numerical view. And if I want to, I can also add some environmental information. I'm now going to be saving the results. I've now saved my results. I could then send this over to my calibration management software, print it out. I would be getting this type of a test certificate. This contains all the same information as we saw on the display. I can choose to file it in paper format or choose to have it in a digital format on the calibration management software. This is how you perform an automatic linearity test on a HART control valve. Thanks for watching this video. See you next time.